Then when I was in Australia, I had quite lovely bosses too, okay? Who taught me. I had Nick Trohanes, I had Joanne, Joe Willocks, and I remember Tracy Gillard, later you'll see her picture. She taught me that actually, when you see a talent in a worker, you must hone it, okay? So she went for a home visit with me, and then she said, you are very gifted clinically, okay? Let's look at doing something else. So we started doing things like that. So I thought the planning part very important. You try to fit a circle in a square peg, cannot work. So I learned that when I was working in child protection and all the stuff. This one, the spark. I realized, right? How many of you here were for the first social workers day in Singapore? The first social workers day. Okay. Do you remember where that was? Arcade, yes, Orchard Arcade. So you know how it started, no? A few clowns, we all were sitting around, then Haley said, hey, we all must have something for social identity. We're like, yeah, definitely a badge, no. Then somebody went, social workers day, she said. Like, yeah, okay. Then we all like, yeah, social workers day. Then all, we started to find a few other people who were very committed. We came together, okay, a few good people. Then we dreamt how the day would be. Okay, what happened after that is, bit by bit, we had a lot of people come and join us, you know. We had people from the prisons, we had people from the youth side, we had people from all over coming to join us to say, yes, we want to do this. But our intent had to be very clear. Why do we want to do this for social work? We had quite a lot of agendas, actually. It was a fun day, but we also wanted to put social work in terms of its visibility. We wanted a space where social workers can come together a day and call it its own. Today, you know, the SASW community is still continuing to organize it year after year. So my appeal is also, please come for that, because it's also one of the things that we do is to pull people together, okay? A group of social workers coming together in a very dedicated way on a same day to talk through issues. Right now we do symposiums and all. To talk through, last year we talked about poverty at length, which is our core business, right? We talked through and we actually talked about how to develop some other additional platforms to address these issues. Then we went out and got resources, some NCSS, private companies, all this. So very quickly, we started to fly, okay? And the day happened. But at the same time, one of the things is there are many projects that we have started. One was the induction camp, social induction camp years ago. But then along the way, there were many, many projects that have happened, you know? But what we also realized is that we really need to pay attention to some people who may find it too fast. That's the reality, right? So for some of us who have been leaders, for us it's like, wow, that one is seem very clear goal, we all just chong, okay? That's how we were brought up, right? We always say, how come we all made our harder stuff? Actually, it's not lah. It's just that we need to tune in to how different people actually taste. And also, it's about diversity. We realize how we can tap on different people. Some are very good planners, you know? Some are very good implementers. Some are very good visionaries. So how do we pull people together to actually achieve that end, okay? Not done, ayah, just do it. Sometimes I'll say that, no, it takes so long, ayah, come on, just do lah, so fast. So sometimes my colleague also give me feedback, say, hey, sometimes you say, this one easy lah, just do only lah. So I say, yeah, but that's because to me, I find quite easy lah. But at the same time, sometimes I think I say that to myself because that's the best way to do it. If I sit down and say, wow, this one so hard, then I take 1 more hour to sit down and talk about it, and then after that do it, it will take. So that, I suppose, but it's how does that come across? So I need to be mindful lah, okay? And to be mindful of power. This is something in leadership we must always be mindful of. So while there are good ideas and we're all moving, right, we also must realize we may have a power differential with our supervisee or the team. So we need to also see how that's coming across, right? Do they have to do it because they don't have a choice? Or is it because of choice? So the dreaming part of a task is very important. What are people's dream about? At the end, how do we want to see the vision, right? How do we want to form this? Yeah. Okay.